around the world, the U.S. government employs about 50 or 60,000 people at its consulates and embassies. And because we're in over 180 countries, over 250 cities, we're actually one of the most diverse workforces in the entire world. We don't really have a choice about it, but it's a huge source of strength for us. And this is something that, you know, is important to us as Americans. We're a nation of immigrants. People from all over the place have settled in America over the past 230 or so years. But it's now something that is a great source of strength for us, as we're able to attract some of the best people in the world because we don't care where they're from, what they look like, what their sexual orientation is, what their race is, etc.
As we are living in a very global world, and definitely Krakow is a very important part of it, we have to possess the basic knowledge of cross-cultural communication. It is extremely important if you want to successfully communicate with people representing different nations and different cultures.
So we had a great debate. We had people that they were from India, from Netherlands. We have a couple of ambassadors of Poland in Africa, in India. We had the consul from USA. So it was great to share some of the ideas that we discussed today, some of the ideas about diversity, how the communication and the language can be a challenge inside the company, and how we can approach them to be able to empower them in daily based activity.
Today, during our conference, we have learned how other nations, how foreigners perceive Polish work styles. And this is typical ethnocentric point of view, because usually we think how we perceive other cultures, but today we as Polish employees and employers, we have learned what challenges other nations have dealing with us.
This conference was a good opportunity to confront different approach to the cultural difference.